Hey, let's go. Physical Science 101. Christian Segura, grade 12, from Alaneros National High School.
Banglab Records.
I just like the sound of it.
Yeah, Aristotle and Galileo's views of motion.
Explain through the rack.
Mic check. Hey, let's go. First, we gotta know if you're tryna roll a ball. When it stop, where it gotta go? When you pick up one and throw the ball, it will escape from your hand like a criminal, like a scary man that laid on a table. The concept of the motion is playing it after all.
The roll.
Yo, Aristotle says on the top, weights are adapt. Everything's down, lighting's up. Fire to the atmosphere lifts it up. One in the violent motion explains the correlation that require a force to conflict a motion. A steady object would move if there's no force or action. So basically, it needs a force externally to make an object move like an alley, like when you throw a ball in a body.
A body.
Yeah, that's Aristotle's views of motion.
While in Galileo's views of motion, he disagrees. You wanna know why?
I listen carefully.
Let's go.
Galileo's upper hand to somewhat different. He proves it by making another experiment. In the motto he proposed, his spirit is determined. After the time of his study, he says that now he notices different. According to him, the object air resistance trying to make it slower, so the speed decreases at any matter. After all, we know that in a vacuum, air resistance rose faster.
Try to make your own experiment to see it clearer.
Additionally, he proposed the concept of inertia. All arrow can fly because the law of inertia. It was because of gravity that exerts internally, and now the data is with Dali.
The difference between Aristotle and Galileo's views of motion. According to Aristotle, if there's force was removed in the object, it will stop from moving. While in Galileo's views of motion, it will stop because of the friction.